sweethearts and lovelies, and welcome back to the new and improved Frezno stream. I am your virtual YouTuber, Freezing Inferno, and we are going to play another game of Mega May. We have been going through the Roll-Chan games, which are hacks of the original NES Mega Man games. And today we are going on to the next in that set. So let's load up this game from 1991. Let's see what the volume's like when it kicks in. 200X. So the household robots were created. This is a recap of everything we did so far. Really, they should have probably put this cutscene in the Mega Man 1. Halfway until the first horror-filled pain of the game. I don't know which one you're talking about, but we'll find out, I guess. Boom, boom, bam, boom, boom. The mad scientist Dr. Wily is attacking with the robots! What do I do? What do I do? Well, Roll volunteered to become a super fighting robot. Roll-chan! Beep, beep. Roll has shattered Dr. Wily's evil plan 3 times! And world peace has made its own, but history repeats itself over and over and over and over again. And now it's time for the mysterious new threat of Dr. Cossack, who's created 8 more robot masters. It's totally not Dr. Wily this time, it's Dr. Cossack. The Soviet scientist, except this is 1991, we have the powerful new Rollbuster! Welcome to Roll-Chan 4. There it is, the Rollbuster. I like this tune. This is an underrated tune. Oopsie, diddle do. It didn't even let me play it all the way. But anyway, here's our bosses: Ringman, Diveman, Skullman, Brightman, Dustman, Drillman, Toadman, and Pharaohman. And we're going to begin with Toadman. Axel created by Dr. Cossack is personal headcanon. So it's raining, we got some things, and also. Check out what we can do! We got a Roll Buster! And a slide. This is what many people call peak Mega Man. It's got a charge and a slide! Not risk the we're back to the energy stopping thing. I like that little QOL improvement from Roll-Chan 3. We're in the water. And there's Robo Rats. That was wild, cause I your first Mega Man game. There are worse games to start with. Hello, Jerry. What was I saying? I remember, like, about 20 years ago, I went to a used bookstore, and, it was in Gander, Newfoundland. Oh, I call it Newfoundland, but the Americans call it Newfoundland, and, I managed to come across a random issue of Nintendo Power from January 1992. It had Super Castlevania 4 on the cover, and it had Mega Man 4 as a feature. So I remember looking at Mega Man 4 and all its coverage. Your sister was dating a gang for coming here. You're trying to impress her by giving your 5-year-old brother the game as a gift. And he gave me Mega Man 1. And then he gave me Mega Man 3. Wow. Not bad. You remind me of this time another person's story, because we'll do this fucking robot snake first before I go reminiscing too hard. Okay. The roll and slide. Okay, once they're here, you hope they never leave. Well, you played about 4 games. Now what the fuck was I gonna say? I got a 1 man after that. Fuck's sakes! Is that a giant robot snail? It is. Alright, what was I about to say? If I start the story, it'll be fine. I remember one summer, my family and I went to Nova Scotia to visit my aunt and uncle. So one of my cousins was a lot older than me, and she had a boyfriend. And so this boyfriend, I knew I was into like old, you know, like Nintendo kids, a lot older. This guy, he has a fucking... He just leaves, like, half his collection of fucking video games to entertain this random 8-year-old. And, like, fucking... I didn't know what the fuck it was at the time, but, like, he lent, like, a shitload of Game Boy games. And also, I didn't know what these were at the time. I just was like, oh, game. It's weird, but okay. Also, a fucking TurboGrafx-16... And the Turbo Express, which is the handheld TurboGrafx-16. I can vividly remember playing, of all things, the fucking Tailspin game on TurboGrafx-16 on the Turbo Express. So that's a thing. That's definitely a thing. Anyway, we're gonna fight Old Man now. And he's a very exploitable robot master, so we're just gonna... just shoot and slide. And he jumps at you. And you shoot... and you slide. It's literally all you do. If you let him sit around and jiggle his ass and twerk, he shoots rain at you. Combat the amphibian. That was funny, because YouTube recommended me one of those silly, like, oh, it's animated Mega Man 4, where it's like, it's just an animated cartoon with dumb jokes. And it's very silly stuff. And one of them was, they got the Toad Man, and it was Rash. And Rash just beats the shit out of Mega Man. We got the Ring Flush. And the Tango Diver. That's a cute robot. So we got that. Who's weak to the rain? Who's weak to the rain? Brightman. Kitty, I don't like Brightman's level. I don't like it very much. But, you know, we're gonna. Yeah, so the gimmick here is it's darkness gimmick. It's a darkness gimmick. These stupid idiots, they just shoot this big spread of bullets. The other little guys, they fire fireworks so you can see again. It's a very annoying gimmick. Then we got these guys who just hammer the fuck out of you. Give yourself carpal tunnel to deal with that shit. Something interesting up there. Totem pole? Yes, it is. It's a very inventive design that this Mega Man video game collection needs. One board. Oh, another one, man. This is gonna be good because I'm gonna fucking die a lot at this. I think I need to get that one. The robot ball thrower, yeah, there's some very strange things, anyway. This is our first, glimpse of these fucking platforms. Okay, was that even fucking possible? I mean, maybe it was possible if I used the tango coil thing. But whatever. I got a life there, so it was basically just, you know... It was basically as if I got an E-tank and I, made it through the thing. Oh, the, power of the Nintendo Entertainment System is, Power of the Nintendo Entertainment System is struggling there, really. Okay, this is the part that sucks ass, actually, this part. Yeah, you got these idiots. It's like, if you fucking shoot them out... Oh, come the fuck! I clipped the edge of the platform and was like, I'm moving, I'm moving, you touched the pixel on me, I'm moving! Oh, for fuck's sakes. I hate this, I don't like this. Oh, Jesus, what is this now? Right, man, you're doing everything you can to piss me off, aren't you? Try not to clip the edge of the fucking platform that you're gonna jump on, so as to make it say, hey, I'm going now! I'm actually going now! I'm a big platform, let's go! Imagine if I shot one of these guys and I had to do all that fucking shit in the dark. Now, here's a little trick, I'm gonna try. Now that I hit him with one of those, he's not gonna counterattack with his flashy thing, I think. Got a time stopper like a Flashman, and if you like he does it at certain points in his health pool, so you just go in there raw with the rain flush, you'll trigger it. But if you hit him with exactly one regular shot and take off one sliver of health, you get it. So. You beat Brightman. Oh, hello. Hey there, music. How you doing? We're going after the Farrowman next. We're going in raw! Farrowman. Oh, this is actually a kicking song. There's robot scorpions. In fact, you might say that there are creatures in this desert. And in this desert, there are certain creatures. I'll get over here. Because there's actually a screen over here! Who would have thought? I got the B, everybody. I skipped like a whole section of fucking level in getting the B. These guys are fine. That one's got me. Let's calm down. robot band. A robot. Yes. I thought I was gonna hit the spikes there, and I did. Ah! Anyway, we're at Faramon, so that's good. They'll give you robot rabies and tell you robot sister of the Korean robot mafia. Wait a minute. Is this another Yakuza reference? Anyway, here's Faramon. He's crazy. He's wild. He's crazy. But it just sits there and breaks shit as you hammer the Y button like a crazy person. Button makes you get shit. You hear that? You hear that? That's the sound of Faramon being destroyed. And that's the sound of my fucking thumb atrophying at this button mashing bullshit. Oh, thank God. Ugh. Jesus. Epic button scan bam gameplay. You know it! Look at me! Man, skills! Just call me Takahashi Mage because I press the buttons far less than 60 seconds. I can't press the buttons every 10 seconds at all. So, Ringman. Yeah! Rings! Ringman's got a fun gimmick. Little disappearing rainbow platforms. What? I almost slid off the platform. Nonsense prematurely. Speaking of nonsense, I don't like this mini boss at all. It's a very impressive effect, but I don't like this boss. You hit it, and you knock it down, hit the thing, but all the time it's shooting its fucking homing missiles at you? Oh, that's how it works. But it's got lives and shit. Down here! Insist upon your getting down here. These little saw blade things. I know this is, I'm starting to notice this game's a lot of blank for the robot. Yeah? Yeah, it be that way. Ooh, another guy. One man. One lady. It's great. Woo! Oh yeah, another mini boss. This ring guy. You gotta charge down. Oh hey, did you like Robot Hippo? Have another Robot Hippo. You can get to a decent rhythm with this boss, but I am having a difficult time doing so. Oh my god. That is very dangerous. Oh yeah, you get a new friend. Well, I'm gonna show off the thing I got. I got the balloon. It's basically just item two from item one from Mega Man. And here's Eddie, the flip top robot, who gives you power ups. He comes along and gives you power ups. That's his job. not really. How many lives? 6 lives. Oh, these enemies are annoying. If they get close enough to you, they go into this like spiral spin thing. It does. Damn it, God. Good thing I was paying attention! Okay. So this ring guy is closer, so he's... Those are robot planets. Yes, they are robot Saturnine planets, aren't they? So I'm gonna throw on the Pharaoh Shot, which is a very fun little weapon. And there's a great trick to it. We'll let you sort of throw up. So we get to charge this giant fucking massive sun over our head to throw at Ringman here. We're actually near death, so I'm going to use that E-Tank. I don't know how that happens. There we go. Robot planets that have been orphaned in space. I see what you're going for there, Mike. He has rings and you're going to throw the sun at him. Yeah, I did throw the sun at him. I kind of got sloppy with that fight. I'm trying to show off the fact that the big sun that goes over your head, if you bonk something with that sun but still keep the button down, you basically have 2 shots, so... Dust. Even Dustman is shrugging! He's like, meh, whatever. You gotta be very careful in this stage. Just these little guys. Come out of the woodwork. And here's just going at a straight pace. You're gonna bonk right into him. And then that'll be the end of your stage real quick, because you're all going to hit and die. Platforms that form themselves. You are persistent, aren't you? Really just homing in on that position. Hey, how about some help? You are a real pal. Okay, so now we got crushers. That's a dangerous situation. We gotta clear out all this junk. So we can get under the crusher bullshit. And not be crushed. Oh, damn it! I was going a little too fast there. That one is all my fault. It's not a speed. We're gonna take it easy. Button dashing your head. Sometimes the zoom takes hold of us. The zoomy noomies. Truer words never spoken. game built in fucking carpal tunnel from Mega Man 4. And he can suck! He can suck! It's Dustman! He's gone from suck to blow! Original name, Suck Man. So, Skull's next. Skull's next. Rah! I'm going to get you. Yeah, these skull guys, you can only get them with a charge shot, so... Whoa! Fuck! So they keep coming back. That's extremely funny to me. We got wiggly worms! Yeah, we're at 9 lives now. Oh, another eater. Should I use the balloon? I'm gonna use the balloon next time. Like that. across this jump? Yeah, that's what happened to these guys. Just don't fucking give me energy. You jump here. Alright, we've Dust Crusher, the Dust Buster. Ah! Ah, I've got the shield on. Bye. He just sort of sits there with his shield on. That's his weapon. It's stand there and make you wait. Oh no! What a terrible weapon. Skull. Dive. I'm a submarine! Decent thing, though, isn't she? There I go. I'm looking for a special something. I'm gonna beat around a bush. Hey, what you got for me? Oh, just what I need. Great. Perfect. Sorry, my fingers fucking hurt when I do that shit. Yeah, they got these monster rays. So. Big miss fucking misses. Oh no, I've fallen down the pit. Oh wait, what is this? Why, this is actually a thing. I got the W! Hey, if you fling yourself down this random pit after the boss fight, you get a fucking special item. Unlike Fairman, it makes you do this whole fucking session over again, which is weird. Oh, one more thing, guys. try. I think I want to go after Dive Man with full health. I remember him being a little obnoxious, so I'm going to try to Buster Duel him, because I'm only on half health. Oh, this is actually easy. Oh, fuck you. That was actually really easy. I don't think I even took a hit. Hardbot speed runs is running no damage. So it's time for the last of the eight, Drillman. Whoa! Disco Inferno, baby. Oh yeah. Fucking lady left, I swear. All the bats wake up at once. I'm shocked there hasn't been a vacuum roller. I mean, Dustman's pretty fucking close. Ladybugs are determined. Oh, these are the next few colors right here. There we go. Oh, I can use the W I got. Whoop. Oh, Broom Man. I am Broom Man with my powerful stick. That was rolling. That was rolling Roll Chan 2, to be fair. It was the Broom Jet. So. Okay, are you just gonna be obnoxious the entire time, buddy? Can you get out of here, Mr. Flying Man? Well, obviously this is a wash, but, you know. If I hit Drill Man once, I'm fine. Oh, yes, I did. Okay, there we go. Alright, now I can fight him with this fucking weakness and not wasting a goddamn energy. Okay. And my weakness is the dive. Miss. Masters beat. We had some ups, we had some downs, but we defeated them all in style rooney. We got the drill bomb. Wow, it's a kitty. And we got tank with you. Now it's time for Dr. Cossack. Hey kids, guess what country Dr. Cossack is from? I wonder what country this guy is from. Surely it is not the country of Russia that he is a citizen of. Surely not. No way. Life and E-Tank is here. 3 and 8. It's an E-Tank. They got slinkies. They got evil slinkies. You heard it here first. In Russia, they have evil slinkies. And ice wizards. That's something I've had to deal with since Flashback. It's snow. In other words, just your average Canadian May. Fuck, I almost got killed over there. Here in Toronto, it was a pleasant 19 degrees. That's nice. That sounds nice. I can just use the balloon, can't I? There we go. Either have that or have the tango, Janet. So I'm going to give a photosensitivity warning again, because usually these fortress boxes, every time you hit them, they're like flashy, flashy, bullshit, bullshit. So, you know, avert your eyes if that's your thing. I forget what this one's weak to. I think it's ring? I think it's ring. I think it's the butterfly one. I feel like ring. see if this is a flashy, flashy bullshit boss. Oh, the boss is flashy. Oh yeah, yep. That's flashy. Yeah. Hey, man, looks different than I remember. Yeah. Yeah, this is Roll, that's because it's Roll Chan, the lady. So that was the robot, Dr. Cossack number one here. That was something. That was a real treat. That was a real treat of a level. Oh, come on! Are there any differences other than Roll? You've got. Hang on. I'll, if I get a chance, I'll show you some things. You got the Tango Cat instead of Rush. That's a difference. Other than that, there's not really that much. I completely forget what bosses is. I'm going to bring the Dust Crusher in, just in case. And photosensitivity warning for whenever this fucking boss dies. Whatever it may be. Where is it? Oh, it's the room! Okay, it's the room. Okay. Tango needs to be used again. Yes. I'm pretty sure dust is. Dust is the weakness of this fucking thing. And M12 needs to happen with Tango in it, and bass and reggae. Flashy warning! They had no fucking concerns for shit. There was like one line in the manual. I remember I rented the game and it had. Oh, there's my push. while playing video games with photosensitive images. And I was like, oh my god, is this game gonna fucking make me die? Oh no! But no, nothing like that happened. Oh, is this the auto scroller? I love this box. I wish it was the whole box of loot instead of crushed up box. It was the whole box of loot. How would you get in there? I wish it was the whole play area. It kind of is. I like the big onion going in the background there. Oh my god. This is shit. I actually want to get on the upper path. That's not bullshit happening. Oh, I actually jumped on that button. I like the color scheme here. Blue and gold contrast very well. That turret told me no. Yeah.
Nope.
You weren't getting that shit. So we got past that auto scroll bit. I don't know if there's another auto scroll bit. I have to see the boss to know what the fuck I want. Wait, no I don't. I want Pharaoh Shot. It's those double walkers. Yeah! Yeah. Now I think I get to show the fun glitch with the thing now. Drop down to get to Dr. Cossack. Okay. go on a quest to rescue her bee, and are there squat dancing robots? We know, it's very complicated. Okay. So I got some branchy pads for shit. But this one seems more difficult to get to. Cossack Fortress is being definitely generous with the intents. Which makes sense. It's being nice. You know, we're on the point, we're on the final level for sure. And that's where the split path comes in. So. I love that. Oh, fuck me. A lot of drill for this. I don't remember what we need. Alright, it's time for the final battle with Dr. Cossack. I think I want Dust again? I'm not completely sure. There he is! The Soviet scientist himself! Dust, Drill, God help me. Ooh, Jesus. What the fuck? My guy, I'm trying to experiment. I'm trying to experiment with Levitier. And you're just fucking with me. It'd be a miracle if I won this. I'm going to try, of course. Wow! That was a miracle! I defeated him! And look, it's Proto Man and a Russian lady. Please roll, don't. My father's not really evil. Dr. Wily took you hostage, forced my father to fight you. Please, Roll, don't hurt my father anymore. Kalinka, father. Roll, forgive me. No problem. Roll! Proto Man gave us the coordinates to Wily's base. Oh no, it was Dr. Wily all along, everyone! It was Dr. Wily all along! He's the true mastermind! He's the villain. And we had to go into another Wily Fortress, another four levels of anguish, and precarious jumping, and I don't know. Proto Man, how are you? That wasn't Proto Man, that was Rock. That was Mega Man. Quite the rascals. The little devils. Not yellow devils. Oh shit. Oh shit, that would be as a weapon. Oh, this is what I'm supposed to go, so I want to get wireframe back up, I guess. To hell with me. That fucking jump directly above you for the block that's about to spawn. Okay, there we go. I'm definitely filling drill out. Standard a ring and give that photo sensitivity warning again because God knows what's going to fucking happen. Oh, it's a giant mech. Yeah, big surprise. Dust? I think I'm just going to bust and just get stuff, frankly. Might as well use one of these, because I got 9 of them. I wonder what the weakness is. I'll try drill. No, it's not drill. Is anything fucking weak to drill in this godforsaken game? Oh, that was mean of you. Flashy, flashy. Two whole E-tanks on that fucking thing. Christ. Like, 4 of the weapons in this game are, like, practical shooty shot things up, obviously work on bosses. Like, you're not gonna use the Bright Stopper on a boss. In all honesty. Unless they're, like, weak to it, for sure. So, what do we got now? Even their fucking propeller. Now we If I can't do it with 7, if I can't do the game with 70 times, well, I have a bigger problem. Okay, you need to go away. Hi, Eddie. What do you got for me? Mario ROM hack levels and instant death everywhere. This is not nearly bad. From what I passed. Mike, I want you to remind me, in fact, well, y'all can check it out after, but I'm gonna DM Mike it. Remind me to tell you about a little hack called Rockman 4 Minus Infinity. When you see some of the shit that game has to offer, it was completely pointless for me to come up here. When you see some of the shit that game has to offer, my god. My good god. Rockman 4 Minus Infinity. Minus Infinity is absolutely nuts. Yeah. I've never beaten it, but my god, it is a hack that you should be fearful of. Yes, you should be in front of me. You should be. Is this your payback for me? No, what? Why? How am I paying you back? I'm just telling you about it. It's not like I'm making you play it or anything. Although, if you want to play it, be my guest. It will certainly be an experience for you. How boss is this? I have a feeling it's gonna be some fucking big, powery thing. What? Oh. Oh, it's Ring. I'm pretty sure it's Ring. Another one of those E-Tanks. Here I was thinking, E-Tanks. Here I am, needing every single one of them. Photosynthesis. For every boss, just. Minus Infinity is really hard, but very cool. Yeah, it's very ambitious for a hack, but Jesus Christ, is it hard. Now what do we got? Down and forward. I'm assuming it's gonna be refights. Definitely need Ring again. Alright, it's Refight City. It's Refight City. Starting with Drill, the fucking dice, the one I don't like the most. Immediately frame one, I'm digging! I got the health before it teleported me out, you bungus. Alright, bright. So. Same as before. Good shot. Shit almighty! You have me in a corner. I hope the bus- Okay. Die. Honestly, I was doing better. Busted. Fighting dive! Scary. Okay, Toad. Oh, we can actually use Toad's weakness now. Time for the hardest boss ever. He's even easier with the drill bomb because he just kind of stands there and lets you hit him. Shrug. Ready? Some fun shit with the drill bomb, or if you like, yeah. Boom! There we go. Yeah, you can't hit him directly with it, you have to blow the thing up, which, in hindsight, might explain why everything was bounced, why the drill bomb was bouncing off everything. You had to detonate it first or some shit, I don't know. Anyway, we've beaten Dr. Wily in first and second form. Now all we have to do is beat the shitty capsule. And we'll have completed the video game. You gotta see where he is in split fucking seconds. Flashing. Hit him. Power of the sun, motherfucker! More will do it. Come on, my boy. Damn. Oh, wait, what am I doing? I'm an idiot. Bye! I just walked right into him. Oh! I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. Oop. I wanted to shoot it, but I guess if I guess he could spawn right on top of the miniature sun and atomize himself. Bye! Uh-oh. Well, let's teleport out of there. Goodbye, Dr. Wily. Base is gonna go boom. Boom, 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 boom. We beamed out. Big Dr. Wily mushroom cloud. Goddamn. Now let's ride the train back home as we reflect on our little video game adventure. I enjoyed Mega Man 4. I enjoyed a little more than I expected to enjoy. In fact, some of the bosses are a little annoying. Weapon set, not the greatest in the world, I mean, only used for. Also, they're like, really situational. I guess they could be helpful in certain situations, like you want to really be homing on something aggressive or you want to screen play it. But you know, sometimes I just like, multi purpose kind of weapons you can just use in addition to your thing. But you know, the Mega Buster kind of. Fucks with that too. I like the streets. Oh, by the way, we'll say it here in the highlight, just because they didn't make it for the stream, but we got a regular chatter in here named the Fantastic Joe, my friend, my kinophile friend. Oh, that's a cute role pose, by the way. We watch a lot of movies together. We watched Casablanca yesterday, and it was fun. But today, May the 10th, is the Fantastic Joe's birthday. So, can we get a happy birthday, Joe? Can we get some happy birthday Joes in chat? For the Fantastic Joe. Come on, my bro. Come on. Happy birthday, Joe. You're a great guy. You got good taste in the games and movies and other such things. And I enjoy it. Joe, so. Very happy birthday to you. This clears for you! Wonderful points in discussion on the Wizard of Oz, Joe. I mean, you might. I don't think I've talked to him about the Wizard of Oz, but I bet you could. I bet you could. I'm looking forward to watching two more of the 90s Gamera films with him. And also, I'm going to show him Kiki's Delivery Service, which is my second favorite Ghibli movie. The number one being Nausicaa of the Valley of the Wind, which I've already shown him. Which is an excellent film. Both of them are excellent films that you should check out while we're talking about movies. And, this is the end of Mega Man 4, Roll Champ 4, what have you. And those 90s Gamera movies are so good. I really enjoyed the first one. I really did enjoy the first one. Looking forward to seeing what kind of fun kaiju nonsense is Some of the best kaiju films ever. I mean, yeah, they're pretty good. Spirited Away. Yeah, we watched that one. That's Joe's favorite, right? Spirited Away. We finally watched that one. It was wonderful. It was wonderful. I really enjoyed that film. Yeah, I mean my favorite kaiju films. I'm of the mindset that the best Godzilla trilogy is the original Godzilla 1984 and then Shin Godzilla. That's what I like. There's a game that's Disaster Report but kaiju. I mean, Shin Godzilla is a great Disaster Report but kaiju, but you know. Person who did the 90s Gamera films worth of amount of Shin Godzilla. Oh, neat. Okay, so there's a little thrill in there. I mean, they're interesting films, and they have a lot more to say than Godzilla vs. Kong, which the amount of political, like, socio-political commentary that film had was, hey, don't give Elon Musk the remains of a kaiju to create Mechagodzilla. Don't let Elon Musk build Mechagodzilla, which, yeah, don't let Elon Musk do things, but also, it's very bare bones. But, before I ramble about movies for the rest of fucking night, I will sign off. Maybe we'll blather about movies when we do Roll Champ 5. I don't know. Fucking prompt me on it if you want, and I'll rant while I'm trying to fight fucking Charge Man. But thank you for showing up to Mega May Part 4, Roll Champ 4. I hope you have a good evening, and well, we'll see you for Roll Champ 5, which will be interesting. In a couple days, we'll do that. And good night, sleep tight, and we'll see. Let's just hop on my dashboard and see if there's anywhere that we can raid a Rooney for fun. To see if there's anyone neat that I can send you to. We're going to send you to Gremlins R Us. She's playing Hades. And I think she's drinking fucking spicy Mountain Dew or some shit. Or I don't know. Well, let's go find out together, okay? Rating. Good night, everybody. Blah, blah, floobity, flah, flah. Okay. All right. So we're going to go over there. And, have a good night.